Ho, ho, ho. Oh, no, that's not for a couple months. People of Earth, how are you? Welcome, good evening, to the 136th installment of the House Arrest Concert Series. With me, your host and sole performer, Bill Spence, live from Mount Laurel, New Jersey. On this October 28th, where it reached 82 degrees Fahrenheit this afternoon, on October 28th, that's 28 degrees Celsius. That's one little bit of trivia that I know. 82 Fahrenheit is 28 Celsius. But anyway, it was warm today. I went out today for the first time since Tuesday. I've been struggling with a cold all week. Three COVID tests say it's just a cold. Started off in the chest, hacking up a lung for a couple days, moved to the head, spewing snot like a fire hose. But, you know, it was a game day decision whether to do this tonight. So if I suck, I'm sick, right? But here I am. Here I am on my second floor area here. As up on the roof as I'm gonna get. When this world starts getting me down, people are just too much for me to face. Came from Jerry Joffin and Carole King from the Brill Building. Just a genius of a song. Carole King herself released it as a single in her 1970 debut album, Writer. It didn't really chart, but number five for the Drifters. And just a great song. All right, you know, you get up on the roof, and you know, there's roof stuff in this next song. But first, I'd like to check my recording device. The recording device appears to be recording. And the audience appears to be minimal. So what one person I'm playing for, who cares? I do, thank you. Sat on the roof and kicked off the moss.
Hope you don't mind that I put down in words.
number 8 hit for Elton John from his second album, 1970. John Lennon was quoted as saying about this song when he heard it first. He says, "Great, that's the first new thing that's happened since we happened." So, he was a fan. It was actually first released in 1970 by Three Dog Night on their album It Ain't Easy, because Elton John opened for Three Dog Night back in 1970 on a tour. He let them record the song. They decided that he'd have a better version of it as a single, so that's how that came about. A lot of time to be alive. A couple years earlier, 1965, let's see if I can do this right.
Yeah, we did.
You think I was kidding you about being sick? That was the Beatles' 7th number one hit in the USA. Done by a bunch of people, including, in 1967, a woman called Kathy Berberian. She's a mezzo-soprano, born in Massachusetts and lived in Italy. And Kathy Berberian, if you're Steely Dan fans, you'll recognize that name from Your Gold Teeth. One of the lines in it that I never knew who they were referring to. I thought it was a friend of theirs. Maybe it was. One of the lines is, even Kathy Berberian knows there's some roulades that can't be sung. So, Kathy Berberian. Ah. She did Ticket to Ride in 1967. What am I trying to do here? I'm going to go to this key. And I'm going to do this. This is a trucker's anthem. I've been warped by the rain, driven by the snow, drunk and dirty, don't you know? But I'm still willing. I was out on the road late at night, seen my pretty Alice in every headlight. Alice, Dallas, Alice. By Lil Feet in 1971. 1968, when Lil George was part of the Mothers of Invention, he played that song for Zappa. And Zappa, weird as he may have been, was actually a non-drug enforcement kind of guy in his dance. So he didn't think the weed, whites, and wine kind of fit in with the Zappa aesthetic. So he said to Lowell, that's a great song. You should start your own band. And he did. Probably one of the best bands to come out of LA. Little Feet. And Willin. It appeared on three of their albums. So today is October 28th, as I mentioned, a couple days before Halloween. It is also National First Responders Day. Well, thank you for your service. It's National Internal Medicine Day. Thank you for your service. It's National Chocolate Day. Thank you for your yumminess. And it's National Hug a Sheep Day. And how that snuck into the mix, but okay. On this day in 1919, the Volstead Act was passed over President Woodrow Wilson's veto. And the Volstead Act enforced the 18th Amendment, which prohibited the sale, distribution of alcohol for alcoholic beverages. And that lasted for 14 years. It began prohibition, 14 years until the 21st Amendment was passed in 1933. So the Roaring Twenties, they were, they were drunk as shit, but they were illegally so. Historically, looking back again, in 1886, the Statue of Liberty on this day was dedicated by President Grover Cleveland. In 1965, the Gateway Arch in St. Louis was finished. In 1636, opened Harvard University. Well, that's pretty loud. I'm glad I wasn't playing. Don't text me anymore, thank you. Anyway, got a couple more songs to do that I have no business doing. Birthdays today. Caitlyn Jenner is 74 today. Julia Roberts is 56. Joaquin Phoenix is 49. And Bill Gates is 68. And I'm not any of those things. I noticed that I'm doing, for the fourth time since the House Arrest Concert Show began, a show that's close to Halloween. It's the Halloween show. I was going to wear a Fred Flintstone shirt, but I think I wore that last year. Anyway, this song originally came out in 1967 as a saxophone instrumental by a guy named Mike Sharp, nee Shapiro. It hit number 57 in 1967. A year later, it hit number 3 with a... The Classics Four evolved over the years into the Atlanta Rhythm Section. In 1979, again, they did a version of this. Cool of the evening when everything's getting kind of groovy. First you say no, you got some plans for the night. Then you stop and say, alright, love's getting crazy with a spooky little girl like you. You always keep me guessing. I never seem to know what you were thinking. And if some fella looks at you, that's for sure your little eye won't be winking. I get confused, cause I don't know where I stand. Then you smile and hold my hand. Love's kinda crazy with a spooky little girl like you. Spooky. If you decide you better stop this little game you've been playing, I'm gonna tell you all that my heart's really dying to be saying. Just like a ghost, you've been haunting my dreams, so I'll propose. That's really the only, excuse me, Halloween song I have. Yes, I've been sick. Born in Kosovo, 1990. Big hats in 2018, 2019. Another one called Your Song, which is the second one I played, different song, written by her and Ed Sheeran. That was a big hit. At one point, she had 13 songs in the top 100 in England. This was one of them. Where did it go? The love that we share, I guess we'll never know. Is it hidden behind that velvet rope while I'm standing alone out in the cold? Know that it's all for show, but did you fool them all into thinking you're gold? Did you do as you told? Will it ever get old? Don't you remember me, darling? When you lay down to sleep, do you still think of me? Without the sadness in your eyes, now the champagne's running dry. Heard that you've been living it up, living it up. Where did I go wrong? Only yesterday you were beside me, beside me. Now I'm just another one, you're the one who's giving it up, giving it up. I'm singing that same song, you're the only one I want beside me, beside me. Now I'm just another one. Singing that same song. high. I bet you felt you could touch the sky. Now you reached the top. Was it worth the climb? Oh, what did you find? What'd you leave it behind? If I were to say that since you've been gone, it isn't the same. And maybe I'm wrong and I made a mistake by letting you go so far away. Don't you remember me, darling? When you lay down to sleep, do you still think of me? Cause I remember you, darling, without the sadness in your eyes. Now the champagne's running dry. That you were living it up, living it up. Where did I go wrong? Only yesterday you were beside me, beside me. Now I'm just another one. You're the one who's giving it up, giving it up. I'm singing that same song. You're the only one I want beside me, beside me. And I'm just another one. I'm singing that same song. Rita Ora. Getting there. Living on bottled water and Tylenol and gummies at bedtime to help me sleep. Stewart of the Kingston Trio, shortly before he left that band, Daydream Believer. one of the few Monkees songs that actually had all four of them performing on it. And the orchestral arrangement in that was done by a guy named Shorty Rogers. I used the same 7-note signature. That was in Help Me Rhonda. Come to an end. That's all the covers I have no business doing. And I'm going to do one of my original songs. Came from an offhand comment. My old songwriting partner and friend, Charlie McKinless, one of his relatives mentioned it. I thought it was his mom, but I come to find out later it was somebody else, not his mom. And anyway. You would ask this person, how you doing? And say, I'm just killing time till time kills me. I'm just killing time. doesn't call for some editing in post. I don't know what does. End of episode 136. Where's my on and off switch on this damn thing? Okay, that's off. And that'll do it. Thanks for joining me. Sometime around Thanksgiving, I'm going to be on a monthly schedule from here on out. And there you go. Ciao, ciao. Great. Everybody watching for that crappy finish. Oh, well.